He has spent a huge amount of time, many years, investigating this story, and he's written a book. It's called Confessions of a People Smuggler, and he joins me from Milan. Giampaolo, welcome to the program. You have talked to about 12 of these people. What is it that they say to you about their trade?
They consider themselves as businessmen. They are very smart and clever businessmen. They observe Europe. They observe the behavior of the European Union. They study the laws. They study the vulnerabilities of the borders and of the laws. But their work is based on the fact that there is a big absence here, the absence of Europe. Europe doesn't give the answer to the migrants and to the asylum seekers. Europe does not provide the service which is provided by the smugglers. Eritreans, Somalis, Syrians, they pay $10,000 to make this journey and to ask for political asylum. So that's the absence of the Europe, the absence of the answer who is feeding this criminal business.
Giampaolo, what do they say when they now see, after all these years of taking these thousands of dollars from these migrants and then watch them drowning offshore, do they have any conscience or is it just about money for them?
Well, it depends on the smuggler. We met a smuggler in Egypt called El Douli, the international. El Douli is working with the Libyan colleagues, with the Libyan smuggling network. He told us, you know, if I bring you to one village in Egypt, I'll be an hero. They're gonna celebrate me. If I bring you to another village, they're gonna kill me and you, because sometimes my clients die in the sea. That's why he told us, I work on the reputation. I try to minimize the risk. But let me underline that they are criminals. They work behind the lines. And the target of European Union is just the boat drivers. It's the wrong target. The people behind the lines who organize the trip, they are very clever and very organized businessmen. Well, at the same time, when they spoke to a journalist, they tried to neutralize their sense of guilty because they are criminals and right. They say, I take care of my clients.
Right. You have called it, you know, you've called it the biggest illegal and presumably deadly travel agency in the world, this criminal human trafficking. How does a trip work? You've said the boat drivers are just the face and just the drivers, but the leaders are sitting behind the scenes and directing all of this.
Exactly. I mean, the real target, if you want to fight this network, is in Tripoli. They are in Khartoum, in Asmara, in Mogadishu, in Islamabad. That's the main point. I don't understand why European Union and our Prime Minister, the Italian Prime Minister, is focusing on the boat drivers, which is the last ring of the chain. The big smuggler, the boss, like the one we met, is able to organize many, many actors, many, many factors. You need people who collaborate. There is someone who can take the boat, someone else who provide food and water, someone else who is going to corrupt the police or asking help for the militia. So many, many people. The main talent of these guys is to establish trust, confidence, make relation, make network. And the paradox is they have exactly all the abilities European Union doesn't show now.
And Giampaolo, one of the ways they get their clients is through social media, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Well, we have a huge variety of searching clients, of marketing strategy. Recently in Turkey with the ghost cargo, we assisted a very huge use of social network and Facebook. But it depends on the country, it depends on the smuggler. The smugglers we met, for example, going back to that example, the Egyptian one, he had a huge network of agents, marketing agents who collect the need and the will of the people of the Egyptian who want to get Europe. And then, you know, it's like a flyer of the travel agency. They get the clients and then they send them to this guy. Who is going to organize the trip until Libya and then Spain, Italy, and so on. So the organization is very fluid, is very quick. They change very, very quick all the strategy in order to get into Europe. I always say they spend day and night, 24 hours, thinking how to get into Europe.
It is an incredible, incredible thing. Giampaolo Musumeci, thank you so much for joining us.